Thank you for joining today's Coffee Break webinar. Today's topic is 3D human brain models, assessing complex neuronal network function in bioengineered neuronal organoids. Studying the human brain in vitro is challenging. Scientists have up until now relied on animal models, like mice and monkeys, but they are an imperfect representation of the human brain. Recently, neural organoids, also known as mini-brains, have emerged as a promising new model. A neural organoid is a three-dimensional human stem cell-derived in vitro culture system that can be studied in a dish. Over time, they can develop complex neural activity that can be similar to the network function present in human fetal brains. This similarity can offer novel therapeutic approaches to neural disease modeling and drug development. In this webinar, Dr. Zaferio, application specialist at the University Medical Center at Göttingen, describes the progressive maturation of the neural network in bioengineered neuronal organoids. Using MAESTRO-MEA technology, Dr. Zaferio is able to detect complex neural network function that mimics early network activity similar to that of the fetal brain. Dr. Zaferio is a group leader at the Institute of Pharmacology and Toxicology at the University Medical Center Göttingen. She completed her PhD degree at the National and Kapodistrian University of Athens and trained as a postdoctoral fellow at the Max Delbruck Center for Molecular Medicine in Berlin. Her lab studies three-dimensional, electrically excitable cell networks generated from human-induced pluripotent stem cells.
Thank you very much for the kind introduction, Melissa. In today's webinar, I would like to talk to you about complex network activity developed in bioengineered neuronal organoids. The combination of neuronal organoid technology with stem cell reprogramming and genome editing present novel therapeutic approaches to disease modeling, drug testing, and potentially tissue transplantation. In order to utilize these so-called brain or cortical organoids for therapy, we first need to validate that they resemble the developing brain in a functional level. Although a number of studies analyzed the cortical layering and the morphology of these organoids, few studies actually were devoted to neuronal network function and compared this function to the developing brain. Aiming to do exactly that, we established a novel bioengineered neuronal organoid model termed BINO. BINOs are generated by embedding human-induced pluripotent stem cells in a collagen hydrogel and by treating them with specific morphogens. Since excitatory and inhibitory neurons are essential for network formation, we aim to enhance the development of both populations early on. Besides neurons, BINOs contain myelinating and non-myelinating glia, which contribute to neuronal function. And microscopically, they are fairly homogeneous. For the sake of time, I will not go into the details of the protocol, but if you're interested, you can find all the information in a recent publication. By utilizing calcium imaging, we found that BINOs around day 20 develop giant depolarizing potentials, as you can see in the videos on the left. These giant waves of depolarization are known to train the developing neuronal networks in the embryonic and fetal human brain. Similar to the immature brain, JDPs in BINOs depend in both GABA and glutamate, since receptor blockade of one or both of these neurotransmitters decrease JTP frequency. On the other side, the spontaneous JTP frequency kept increasing in time, but after day 40 to 45, no JTPs could be observed. By a series of experiments, we could prove that in early stage BINOs prior day 40, both GABA and glutamate were excitatory and contributed to JTPs. Whereas after day 40, GABA polarity switched to inhibitory and led therefore, to low JTP frequency as it actually happens in early postnatal brain. These exciting findings prove that neuronal networks in Beanos are organized in a similar fashion as in the developing brain. Although calcium imaging experiments were extremely useful for JDP analysis after day 40 when GABAergic neurons became inhibitory, network analysis was technically impossible in the whole organoid. Therefore, to monitor network activity on Beanos after day 40, we employed the multi-electrode array technology from Axion Biosystems. MEA allowed us to measure simultaneously multiple organoids under cell culture conditions, and most importantly, we could follow the temporal network development. As you can see here, early stage organoids showed relatively sparse activity that slowly organized in bursts and network bursts, which after day 40 became more and more complex. If we examine the temporal network development, it is clear that the mean firing rate increased significantly in late-stage Beanos. Although the burst and network burst frequency did not increase after day 40, the synchronicity increased, as well as the amount of spikes participating in the bursts, resulting in a reduction of interspike interval. The lower interspike interval indicated a more mature burst identity in late-stage Beanos. This data strongly support the notion that Beanos present similarities to the brain in not only cell composition, but also in how neuronal network function develops, and thus can be used for disease modeling. Since epilepsy is one of the most prevalent neurological diseases generated by network imbalance, we believe that Beanos can be used to model and study epilepsy in Zwitch. Just as a proof of principle that we can observe and analyze network imbalance, you can see in this slide the activity response to two opposite chemical interventions. GABA receptor inhibition by picrotoxin in the upper wells, or AMPA receptor inhibition by CNQX of late-stage Beanos in the lower wells. In the video and the raster plots on the right, you can see the first minutes during compound addition, whereas in the left you can appreciate the activity of Beanos after washout. As expected, activity in Beanos treated with CNQX was immediately diminished and returned to baseline 24 hours after treatment. Interestingly, picrotoxin boosted immediately Beano activity, which remained higher 24 hours after washout, establishing a new baseline and suggesting a form of chemically induced long-term potentiation, which is actually known for the mouse hippocampus. This data support that spontaneous activity in Beanos responds to chemical treatments similar to what we know for the brain, and therefore we believe that Beanos would be an appropriate system for modeling epilepsy in a dish. To summarize, Beanos generated from induced pluripotent stem cells embedded in a collagen hydrogel consist of excitatory and inhibitory neurons, as well as myelinating and non-myelinating glia. Around day 20, Beanos developed giant depolarizing potentials known as JDPs, which are GABA and glutamate dependent. JDP frequency correlates to GABA polarity. And after GABA polarity switches to inhibitory, Beanos develop complex network activity and exhibit plasticity. Since features of network development in Beanos present similarities to the human brain, we believe that they will prove to be a useful system for personalized medicine. I hope I could give you a little glimpse on the network function of our organoids, and if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to contact me. At this point, I would really like to thank people that contributed to this work, and especially an excellent electrophysiologist, Guobin Bao, and two young students, Alisa Blenkle and Marie Schreiber. And of course, this work would not have been possible without our financial support by the Multiscale Bioimaging Cluster of Excellence and DZHK. Thank you very much and have a wonderful day.
And that is the conclusion for today's Coffee Break webinar. If you have any questions you would like to ask regarding the research presented, or if you are interested in presenting your own research with microelectrode array technology or impedance-based assays, please forward them to coffeebreak@axionbio.com. For questions submitted for Dr. Zaffirio, she will be in touch with you shortly. Thank you for joining in on today's Coffee Break webinar, and we look forward to seeing you again.